Hello, this is Nintro U. After about half an hour's work, I finally got audio working on this. So, welcome to what will hopefully be the first of a couple of comparison videos, which I will hopefully end up compiling together into one video, because, you know, maybe I'll one day get good at using video editing software. Today I will be playing Dark Flame LEGO Universe. Lovely little thing down there. Woo, DLU, yay. I've got access to a couple of servers, and so I'm going to try and produce some sort of comparison videos. I'll try and do similar things in each video, just so you can see how state of play is sort of spread across different servers. I also have no idea what my password is. I don't know if it's the same as it is for the forum, so this might not work. No, to clarify, none of this has been pre-planned. This is, like, first attempt. Oh yay, random character feature. Everyone else seems to remember vaguely what their character looked like from LEGO Universe. I can remember a lot about Infamous, but I cannot remember what on earth he looked like. So, I'll be probably working off of just trying to create, to an extent, a Nintro U character, because Nintro... Well, we just saw a glitch number one there, because Nintro U never actually was a character I had. Okay, we're noting that doesn't like me choosing decals, let's try and persuade it to. So that will also explain some choices I'm making, such as the fact that Nintro U isn't actually going to be, despite my love for assembly, which rivals even that of Kitty's, Nintro U is not going to be a member of the assembly. That will be saved. That great honour will be saved for Infamous. For those of you who wonder why I'm spending so much time trying to find something for Nintro U, he already has a personality of sorts. From several roleplays, and I on the DLU forums, I would recommend. That was not what I clicked on. Okay, let's try that again. But yeah. So he already has a personality of sorts, and I'm just trying to make him fit that personality insofar as possible. It's over the top. I know that it's only a game, but I don't have much else to fill my ultimately meaningless existence on this planet with. So, yeah, I'm spending my time designing a character for the universe. I think I may have just gone all the way around and gone the same eyebrows. Anyway. See how long it takes me to get banned if I change my temporary name to Kitty Jumpy Phone. Yeah, I really hope all of this is audible. I should probably check the music alphabet, definitely. I should probably check my audio hasn't just turned itself off. No, I don't think it has. Hey. Please. Shame. That was worth a try. No plagiarism at all here. Hey Kitty, if you're watching this. Okay, so... From experience, when LCDR first got running, they had issues with this screen here. Now, I would expect those issues to have been resolved in DLU's first alpha, if they ever occurred. I don't remember there being huge issues here. In LCDR, there was a bit of a glitch, which led to me somehow creating I think it was like 7 characters on the main screen, which ended up just crashing my account. And I could never get past this screen until I had Words for OCDR and fixed it. Had Words for OCDR, let's say, and it's far more confrontational than it was. I basically went up to him and says, "Please make my account work." Okay. We've got some lag. I mean, presumably it's server lag. I don't know what, how many, I mean, it could be a bug. I don't know how many players are. Oh, yay, are online at the moment, so server lag may or may not be reasonable. For those of you who have watched previous DLU videos, yeah, they do. The server hasn't always been amazing. Okay, rendering's fun, but there's half chance that's just, like, more than half chance that's just my computer. I know I haven't messed with this client yet, though. Okay, you're going to. Oh. It's up to the challenge of the game when you can't see where things are. This should be fun. There's a rather significant chance that this is will be something I've done to this. It'll just be my computer lagging, my computer. Okay, looks like I'll be getting used to doing this from memory. So that's the sort of little circular bit in the center. Fortunately, we've still got the decals to give me some idea of where to go till I can't move. And oh, so crates appear to be fully working. Nice. Let's check out this. So in terms of prod, I don't even know if I'll be using this audio with this video in the end, but in t I'm noticing I'm not getting a little voice in my ear congratulating me for double jumping. That may be because I've turned it off. I begin to forget what I've done. I've edited a lot of things in random clients. Yeah, so I was saying, I will be producing different videos. Currently, I think stuff like Jailus, just because people are interested in that sometimes, maybe, please. Be doing videos on, yeah, Jailus, definitely LCDR. I've already posted videos, but I'll try and get some sort of comparison video out. And if, depending on how Pylus goes, I will see if I can get videos out on there. This one appears to be right. Okay, so far I'm noting there aren't any other players, so if that was server lag at the beginning, I'm not certain there was a huge reason for it. This is another fairly common place to get server lag, and there wasn't much there. If I ever end up posting videos of Jailus playthroughs, you will see the true meaning of server lag. Although in fairness, that's not just Jailus. Like, Jailus isn't amazing, but yeah, okay. Binoculars have been working since Luni, so and gravity happened. Well, it certainly adds a whole new challenge to it. The other thing is now I've got my imagination. Let's go over here and try some quick builds. These are often fairly nice tests of where the project is in terms of development, but like, I'm pr almost 100% certain I saw quick builds in previous DLU testing. I would be like, they'd have basically have to have gone backwards. Like, Jailus is basically a quick build. I'm noting I'm getting similar rocket. Why did I go for binoculars? I'm noting I'm getting similar rocket types. That may just be that I'm a very lucky person. Could be some sort of, or not rocket types, but rocket colours. Must be a glitch. Okay, I'm gonna try and get my way back down. Have the ability to see where it is I'll be landing. Yay! Yeah. So for future LU challenges, this is a nice one. Can you make your way around Venture Explorer without being able to see? Okay, I'm lagging. I should probably turn my computer's power on, so my computer has a habit of running out of power precisely when I need it not to.
Okay, where do I go? Can has LU hacks? Am I lower than I should? Oh, I'm in utterly the wrong place. Skills. Alright, let's go. So, current information, I mean, quick builds are working. We've got this weird ground glitch, but I don't know if that's happening for multiple users. Like, I'd have to assume it isn't. Just because it seems like something large enough that DLU would have done something about it. I've got lag, but that will be my side, presumably due to... it seems to be the fire animations. Just don't particularly know where I go from here. Oh, I forgot stairs were a thing. I really don't want anyone in the community ever to see this video, although I'm going to post it on YouTube. Like, I really hope no one ever watches it. Which fortunately probably will be the case. But yeah, okay, so buildy, buildy, buildy. Woo! Hello, Skylane. Mission tracker. Let's click a button and get some points. Yay. I think. Okay, another pink one. Oh no, okay, so it is just me by chance getting the same one multiple times, that's fair enough. There's a cartoon strip I saw once. It's a stats mocking cartoon strip basically saying, oh, I've got a random number generator. And the person just goes 99999. And the argument is that, yeah, it doesn't look random, but it's statistics. That could be random, and we just, like, you can't prove it or disprove it. Actually, if people have heard of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle in quantum physics, that 999 joke's actually sort of an analogue of that. Where I've probably lost most people at this stage, in case it has not already been recognised, I am a nerd. Proud one, but still one. Oh yay, rendering's happening. Maybe that'll mean other stuff will have rendered, or probably not. Yay, Brian Tyler music. Such good music. Okay, so, I mean, for a while, like, you couldn't get... on DLU you couldn't get out of Venture Explorer, so that's progress. LCDR you can get out of Venture Explorer. So if we're measuring in terms of worlds, which is a really bad measurement, then LCDR is up to Nimbus Station. JLS is... I can't remember. I seem to remember weird issues going to Avant Gardens. You can get there, but not much is implemented there. Like, the game's only anywhere near functional within the Venture Explorer. So if DLU can make it to Avant Gardens, even measuring in terms of worlds, it's doing pretty well. Although, I should add, because otherwise I will get rage, specifically from Kitty, but also from other people, saying you should not measure the game's progress in terms of worlds. So, what we mean by this is, for instance, if you implement, as a programmer, if you implement missions on one game, in one part in your code, then those missions will be implemented throughout the world. So what makes any one particular world harder than another is what features it has implemented within it. Now, whilst I can go to Avant Gardens and Nimbus Station on LCDR, there's quite a separate thing being able to go there and, for instance, having 100% of the functionality there. I, for instance, can't remember, but I don't think LCDR has pet taming. I believe DLU. They certainly teased that they did. I would assume they do. They're not the type to put out a teaser and then not actually have it. Because that's what Looney does. Yay. So I would always be careful measuring it by worlds, because you can get to Pet Cove on Looney. That doesn't mean you have pets. So, yeah, it's something always to be wary about. It can be a good measurement if the worlds are completed, because as you get further on, like, certain worlds may require, like, different functionalities. But on the whole, you want to measure game progress in terms of features, probably not in terms of worlds, and stuff like server stability. So, partially that's to do with bugs, glitches, but you also want to consider just how, like, sometimes, especially, all these server projects use a program called, or a package, I don't know if it counts as a program, I don't know what it counts as, called RackNet, for communications between sort of the server and the client. Now, RackNet sends data in ways which can be dubious in terms of potential data loss, and so a huge part of this is sort of getting rid of, like, LCDR's had several issues in terms of transmission of data. Not in terms of security or anything, because let's face it, you're not putting your credit card details in here. Please, mate, do you pay to win? That'd be funny. But, or crates. Darwin loves crates. Loot boxes, sorry. But you can get, like, lost data. And so as you pile on more and more players, sometimes these issues sort of come more and more pronounced. And so that's, server stability is a pretty important ranking for a server. Server speed shouldn't be too huge an issue. Like, there are two reasons why your server speed could be slow. If I'm running my version of JLS, say, on this computer, then this computer isn't amazing, it's pretty slow, it's years old. You're not going to get much impressive out of it. However, if I run... Sorry, I heard a beeping earlier, that might be... Oh, I've got a message on Discord, someone likes me. Yeah, I'm sure they don't. But... I've forgotten what I was saying. If I ran it JLS on this machine, then it would be slow for two reasons. First reason, because my machine's slow, but the second reason is because of the code of JLS. Now, if I move to a faster machine, then it will go faster, but my code still won't necessarily be that efficient. However, if I've got a far more polished piece of... Sorry, I'm always dissing JLS, I apologise, but I think no one will be too greatly offended. But you can also optimise the code, and, like, certain languages are famously better at that than others. I say famously, but that's the reason why, for instance... I don't know, Microsoft Small Basic has very rarely been used to program any games. I mean, partially it's not particularly powerful, but yeah. Okay. This is like one of those Windows loading bars that's sort of percentage complete, 99% complete, loading, about 2 hours. There are still things flashing up there, so it gives me hope that maybe something is happening, but doesn't appear to be loads. Please hold. Your game is important to us. I get a picture. My network use. I've just got task manager and taking a look. Oh, yay. Good. Oh, it's a person. This might be a useful point at which to... test some functionality here. Just gonna go through. Probably shouldn't block them. Let's report them. Nah, I'll be a nice person. So I'm still having rendering issues. On the other side, it's a lot easier to see where the heart flags are. There was one over the other side as well. Okay, now this is going to be the greatest test of DOU, because one of the huge things which makes LCDR not like playing the original is Stromlings. Now, I know for two reasons DOU should be better with this. Firstly, they've got a load of scripts extracted from, I can't remember precisely where extracted from, when the game was live. Yeah, it doesn't look too promising. But they also have, I'm not certain if he still is, a developer working solely on scripts. On getting AI working. Okay, doesn't look like it's working. So at this point, DLU appears similar to LCDR, let's see. Okay. Potentially, on that measure, behind, I know it's bricks aren't rendering, but that's probably my, like, you've got those question marks, but that's probably my side. I'll have to see if I've accidentally messed around with settings or anything. So, an LCDR, if I went up to these, they would attack me. They wouldn't, they'd attack me, they'd damage me, they wouldn't run at me, but if I went up and sort of hit this, I shouldn't have actually punched it whilst it was doing it. If I just walked into it, then it would begin to attack me. So it doesn't appear to be the case here. But on the other hand, it doesn't appear to be hugely buggy in terms of number of spawns. Okay, that might be a little bit of server lag there, where it might have just not dropped anything full stop. Or maybe they don't actually. I noticed not always dropping things in LCDR. I think they should drop something. Anyway. Okay, no. When this starts happening, you can be willing to bet it's server lag. So in a couple of seconds, I'd expect myself to suddenly get glitches. But so yeah, that's the one thing I think we can conclusively say. There is still a fair amount of server lag that hasn't been entirely fixed. I'm half expecting this to just be a trail of coins now. Or it doesn't feel too implausible to expect it. Yeah, again, this happening. I don't think this is my connection being blocked in some way. No, doesn't look like it. It's all interesting to see what stuff, like how the game breaks up, what is rendered and what, like. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, I think there we are. Drops much. I'm not going to be able to collect everything before it disappears, am I? There we are. Yeah. In explanation, I noticed my imagination went down, therefore something must have happened. Yes, yeah, so presumably the other person online was doing something, and that did a thing. And it went slow. Technical descriptions with Ninja. Oh god, I've got server lag again. Anyway. I've got the points of those because they've like, I don't think they have any different stats to your hands. Well, I suppose they might have like a different, like their damage is the same as your hands, but their reload time might be different. Oh yeah. Really? Okay, so I'm getting given the wrong items. Oh no, okay, the item's just lagging when they're given to me. Those I'm pretty certain should not be linked. This certainly cannot be linked. That should have opened, but yeah, so that's not gonna, fortunately the functionality won't actually let it continue. Anyway, I've equipped it. What do you want? Does this count as an attack? It would appear it does. Okay, so I'm not going to be doing an entire playthrough right now, partially because I need to make dinner, and it'd be nice to eat. I haven't eaten food, and I like, well, I sort of need eating food to live. Hashtag harsh realities in life. But on the other hand, life hacks. Just eating helps. Eating helps kids remember to eat. Okay, so probably stop at some point around this mission. I don't know. Paradox Protector. Yeah, so also points like that. Double jumping, I know in LCDR I would have been hit by the Stromling. I should just say, I am not, because people may think, oh, he's a mod for LCDR, he's being biased. I'm not saying like it's good or bad, like half of this stuff about the AI, I know with LCD, I should have actually checked. With LCDR, half of it's just put in there sort of to like enable other functionalities. And to sort, like it's, and AIs really aren't complete, like there's a fair chance that what DLU just want to do is get the entire AI system complete before releasing any of it whatsoever. But what I can say is at the moment, there's nothing in the way of AI. Whether that's good or bad, I'm not, people can come to their own conclusions, I'm not going to judge one particularly unless I say I'm judging them, in which case I'm judging them. But what's the thing about, you can, it's, like, you should only throw stones if you yourself are blameless. Like, I'm not a good enough developer to have made LU, so I can hardly criticise. I've got some level of experience with it, but I can hardly criticise people who have actually gotten this far when I would be nowhere near this myself. So, like, I can't criticise, I can at least say what I see and what I know. Okay, I'm hoping he'll let me through the side here, because presumably the ambulance is down. I should say, I know the mission chain, stop telling me to equip it, I can't equip it. I believe the mission chain goes a fair ways. But I'm not certain if I should be getting those if I can't equip them. Maybe I should. I can't remember. Actions. I might need to be saluting or something. That's what she asked me to do. Yeah. Salute. Okay, so I still, so I appear not to have yet received that. Hashtag set for lag. I'm waiting. Anyway, yeah, okay, so this is rather a good, yeah, how can I get him to face me? Yeah. This might be a rather good time. So yeah. For now, I've also got to get a better character. That does not look how I pictured Montreal you would look in my mind. For now, I'm going to say goodbye. I don't even know if I'll use this audio, but I might publish these things separately and then put them together. But yeah, thanks for watching my first, yeah, this is the first time I've been on DLU. Like, hype? This is, I've heard about, been hearing about DLU for years, and so, like, I said I was going to start, didn't I? But yeah, I've heard about DLU for years, and I can't believe I'm actually playing it now. Anyway, presumably you're all done with me talking, so, yeah. It's been cool. Let's make use of this again. See you all around. Now I've got to stop the video.